A Columnstore index in Azure SQL Database provides a very high level of data compression, typically up to 10x. This can both reduce the storage cost and improve the performance of your database. And Davide Mauri is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Welcome back, Davide. It's great to have you back in Azure Friday talking about Columnstore indexes. Mm. So tell me, what are these indexes and why do they matter?
Yeah, so it is one of my favorite topics. Well, I guess all are my favorite topic in Azure SQL. Sorry, just kidding. No, so let me talk about Columnstore because these are really amazing. So first of all, I think personally that Azure SQL is the only cloud database that allows to have both row store and column store index on the same table at the same time. Now, you may be wondering, well, what's the big deal here? Because it's just two indexes, right? Yeah, that's true. But let me show a little bit why it's so important and how different these indexes are. I prepared a couple of slides because this could be a little bit more a technical topic than the usual. So let me switch to the slide a second. So here we go. So let's say these are a table, right? So we are storing name, surname, email, and whatever. A usual row store index is an index that takes basically all the data you have in your row and store it together. So if you, let's say if you are looking for an ID equal one, all the other values, David, Moore, and you know, email, whatever, are close to each other, right? Are physically close to each other. And this is perfect when you want to, given the ID or the email, you want to get all the other values. So again, it's perfect for what we usually say, it's a singleton search or you know, accessing the entire row of the data. But what happens instead, if instead of being interested in you know, all the other data in the same row, you just want to say, oh, I want to aggregate data and see how many David or Ada or Mike there are in my system. Well, reading also the surname and the email is basically just wasting a little bit of resources because you want to count the name, not the surname. So it would be better if we could store the data by column instead of by row. So as you can see, a column store takes all the value highlighted by the green box, so all the names, and store them together, which means that every time you want to access all the names, like counting them, well, they are physically close to each other and you don't have to read the ID or the email or any other column.
So that's going to reduce some of the IO. It's going to reduce the memory. Oh, great.
Everything. Okay. We can optimize the read of the entire column in an amazing way. We are even using some special instructions that are in the CPU that are used to do vector computation. So, you know, for 3D games, to basically do the same computation here. And this makes the performance go so fast that is incredible. And the beauty of Azure SQL and SQL Server, but specifically Azure SQL Database in this case, is that they can exist in the same table. So many systems allows you to have all the row store, and then you have export the data into a column store database. And of course, that is also good too, but then you have two databases, two different systems that you have to maintain. With Azure SQL, everything is just one place, and you don't even have to, you know, maintain the index in the sense that you don't have to worry about data being out of sync, because everything is on the same table, and we do all the work behind the scene for you. So by having those two different type of indexes, let's say now the put aside for a second the technical aspect, for a developer, what are the important things to remember? Well, row store is great for singleton lookup or when you want to scan data in an order, like give me, you know, all the data for all the people with a certain surname. And that's perfect, for example, when, you know, you have to retrieve, I don't know, a shopping cart, for example, because you want to have all the data for the shopping cart returned. And instead, the column store is perfect for when you when you want to do like reporting or analytics, like what is the average size of my shopping cart, right? So we can really scan the data on the column very, very quickly and very fastly. If you are interested in a little bit of detail behind the scene, we do quite a lot of interesting stuff here. So we take all the table, all the rows that we need to load. We split it in row groups to avoid to have, you know, a huge amount of memory to be allocated. So we work in groups of rows. And each row group is split in column segment. So basically all the column is, you know, managed separately. And each column is then compressed using various stage of compression and very different techniques of compression. So, for example, you can imagine in a let's say, a billion row table where you store cities of the world. Well, there are not 1 billion cities in the world, right? So probably names will be repeating very frequently. And we can compress the repeating names amazingly. Like we use 10% is probably a good indication, but we can even go more than that. So depending on how compressible is the data. And an amazing thing we did in the last years is that usually you can imagine that all this compression make read very fast, but writing data into a column store is pretty complex because it's not like you just save the row, right? You have to go through all these steps and probably that will slow down at some point your performance when you have to read when you have to write or change the data. So we also created something called a Delta Store that has nothing to do with what Apache did for Databricks. So I would say the principles are similar. We did this in 2012, if I remember correctly, so long ago, and it just happened that the name is the same, but the principle and the logical principle are similar. So we allow you to update the column store in the sense that we allow you to write into the column store, but we do a little trick. Every time you write, we actually write the entire row. And when the number of rows that you have written is big enough, we convert it into a row group and a column segment, and we merge it into the column store. So basically, we remove all the complexity for you to have a updatable column store, and that's it. This is kind of the magic that we do. You still use something that is very complex to manage, but it's very simple to use, and that can really make a huge difference in your performances.
And so the advantage for us as developers by having both the column store and the row store indexes, mm-hmm. we don't have to think about how to optimize for performance based on certain query patterns. The engine takes care of it for us.
Exactly. So let me show, prepare a simple demo. So for example, here I'm showing, for example, how you can create different indexes, also because there is something interesting here. So the first one is a usual clustered index. Let's say it's just a typical index that people are used to have on a table. And you notice that, of course, we have to specify the columns on which we want to create the index because the column and their position, the ordering of this column is important because basically an index, and this again, it's the columns, it's the row store index, orders data for using the logic specified here. So my data will be physically ordered by order key and line number. Ordering is basically what make a row store index fast because we can mm-hmm. search the data quickly. Now, what happens if I instead create a column store index? You notice that there are no columns here, right? Because with a clustered column store index, we are creating a column store index on the entire table. So we don't need to ask you which columns you want to create because we create the index on all the columns. And this doesn't affect performance at all because each column is saved separately. Okay. And we only access the column that you are specifying in the query. So this is a complete and different approach from row store indexes. Now, for those who doesn't know what a clustered index is, no matter if it's column store or row store, well, basically, let's say, simplify a lot, that the cluster index is actually the table. So that's why here I'm creating a column store index on one table and a row store index on another, because physically here I'm deciding, and just to show the example, I'm showing you how you can create a cluster index, both row store and column store. But let's take a look at this. Actually, let me do another sample here. I created another table where I create a regular row store clustered index because I want to be very fast to find an order by specifying the order key mm-hmm. or the line item. So I want to be super fast going to that specific order number. But also on the same table, I'm creating a column store index. Non-clustered means I am just selecting some column I want to use to create the column store index because those column is those I will be using, for example, in a reporting scenario. And I'm creating a column store index on top of a row store index, which means that my table will be super fast in finding data by row, but also will be super fast every time I want to find how many rows are in process or how many rows has been delivered yet. this is amazing because, as you said, a developer doesn't have to compromise anymore. You just create a table. You want performance to find a single row. You have it. You want to have performance to improve your aggregation and end of month report. You have it. So this is really something that can improve performance and developer velocity a lot. And how much and or what a lot means here. So let me show you. Here I have a somehow small database. It's a hyperscale generation 5, 8 core. So not exactly huge, but still decent. And this is my table. So I have, order key, the part number, quantity. It's a typical order table. And actually, this comes from the TPCH standard database. Now, let's count how many rows I have here. And here I'm using the row store table. And as you see, it takes a while, but it's 60 million rows. So mm-hmm. What happened here is that Azure SQL had to read all the 60 million rows physically, starting from the first up to the last one. Now it took a little bit more than a second. Let's do the same on the column store. Wow, that's sensibly fast.
Yeah.
Because here we don't have to read the rows, all the rows. We can just pick one column, maybe the smallest one, and read that, right? And actually, I say that it's compressed. We can do tricks with the vertex processing. So you can already sense the speed. But now let's do that. Let's do a group by query. I want to see all the rows for which the quantity is greater than 300. Let's do it on the row store query, on the row store table. Well, we have to scan all the rows and do the aggregation and, wait.
Yeah.
Okay, that's taking a lot. Let me stop it. Let's say what happened if I switch to a column store, right? So 12 seconds passed and we didn't get the answer. So let's see what happened with the column store. Oh, wow. Okay. I was about to start to say, let's wait. And it's here. It's a lot, right? It's probably more than 10x this performance. So this is the beauty of the column store. And of course, here I'm just for the demo using a column store or a row store, but remember you can use together. And everything also works nicely, even if you are more complex query. What if I have a group by, and then on top of this group by, I do other computation? Well, still it's very fast because basically, we can take advantage, for example, of even of better caching in the CPU core because we can push all, cache the data of the same column and do more operation on it very fast. And in fact, if I go to explain and go here and take a look at the execution plan, you can see something called the execution mode is batch. Batch means we can work on a set of row instead of a row by row. Mm-hmm. And this means that, again, we can do some average or computation like that in a more efficient way. So
not only is this improving the performance, but as we called out earlier, it's also improving your storage costs because you're storing a lot less data. Information. Yes.
Yes. Okay. So you're basically, it's a kind of also compression. It saves several resources. Storage on disk, storage in memory, which means your memory usage is more efficient. In general, CPU resources. That's beautiful, even because everything I just showed, if you remember in one of the first episodes, we discussed about windowing function.
Yep.
Right? Now we start to put things together. So let me show you my last demo. Here, I'm using, if you remember, we discussed about the lag. Lag is the ability to look at the rows before mine. So let's say I have a list of here, and I want to calculate the growth ratio, right? Well, I can aggregate the data, as I did before. Then I can use the lag operator to say, take, 2020 and look at 2019 and calculate the previous quantity, and then calculate the difference, and then calculate the grow ratio. Mm-hmm. This is done on the 60 million rows table, right? So let me, I will not even try to run on the row store, but on the column store, calculation like that can be done pretty quickly, this is basically real time, and this is only an 8V core. Like it's literally my phone has 8V core today. So this is pretty impressive, I would say. And this enables a huge amount of scenarios for HTAP, so a hybrid transactional analytical processing, where you have data coming in, you need to access the single row, but you also need to present a dashboard or a report. This is something really exciting, honestly, for me.
Yeah, so we're saving on storage costs, we're saving on our compute costs, we're getting increased performance, and I don't have to think about it.
Yeah, and more importantly, you have only one database that you have to learn and love, because you don't have to spread data across several different, more specialized storage, which I guess, you know, some cases they are super useful, but in many cases, you are just happy having one thing that has a lot of stuff together and basically remove all the integration problem that are probably the most complex problem to resolve. So everything is here. You don't have to move data around. Don't care about, you know, having out of sync data, old data, stale data. That's beautiful to me.
And there's a lot more to learn about column store indexes, mm-hmm. and, you know, when and how to use them, how to design them. Where can I go to learn more?
Oh, yeah. So we just, Nico, one well-known MVP, just joined us. He wrote, I think, I don't know, hundreds probably blog post on Columnstore. So we'll make sure to share the link in the description. Here you can learn everything literally about the Columnstore. Of course, there is our documentation. But yeah, that's the place I would go.
Thank you very much. It's been great hearing all about Columnstore indexes from Davide Mauri today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.